हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर सुभाष साहू, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ त्रिपेगुण. इन द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द डिस्कशन अबाउट वेदनास्थापन ग्रुप, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट ए कॉमन प्लांट दैट इज रसोनो और लसुन. बोटनिकली दिस इज नोन एज एलियम सैटिवम. It belongs to Liliaceae family or Liliaceae family. In Hindi, it is known as lasun. In English, it is known as garlic. As per Bhavaprakash Nighantu, when Garuda snatches Amrita from Lord Indra, a drop of Amrita is fell on the earth from which lasuna came into existence. It is devoid of one rasa, that is amla rasa, so it is known as rasona. It is not included in any gana of Brihatrayi. Neither Charaka or Sushruta or nor Bhagavat has mentioned in any Mahakasaya or any Varga. But it is extensively mentioned for the treatment of Vataraga and as a rasayana in Brihatrayi. The term lasun is more frequently used in the Chikitsa Grantha than the term Rasona. Bhagavat has considered Rasona as the best drug among the Vatahara Dravya. He also emphasized to use Rasona Rasayana in the treatment of all types of Vata Avarana except the Avarana of Rakta and Pitta. More interestingly, Kashyap Samhita and Harit Samhita has described a separate chapter or mentioned a separate chapter entitled Lasun Kalpa about the detailed information about the plant Rasona or Lasun. According to US FDA, the survey among 900 people, garlic stands is the second most utilized supplement behind the echinacea, with almost 17% of population using garlic as a supplement. It is a most utilized product which is used by the common people or the people throughout the universe. Then vernacular's name. In Assam, it is known as Maharu. In Bengali, it is known as Lasun or Rasun. In Gujarati, Lasan. In Kannada, Baluchi. In Odia, Lasun or Rasuna, like that. Then synonyms. It is known as Arista. Arista means no evil eyes would affect an individual which is using Lasun. It is known as Bhutagna. Bhutagna means it destroys evil organisms. So it is known as Bhutagna. Then Lasuna. It is quickly absorbed in the body, so it is known as Lasuna. Then Mahakanda. It is a very potent drug for all type of diseases. So it is known as Mahakanda. It is also known as Mahosadha. Mahosadha means it is one of the best medicine to treat various diseases. Then Mlechakanda. Mlechakanda means it is liked or used by the Mlecha people, so it is known as Mlecha Kanda. Then Rasona, it is devoid of one rasa, that is Amla rasa, so it is known as Rasona. Rasonaka, it is also the same meaning. Then Sitamardaka, Sitamardaka means it removes cold from the body, so it is known as Sitamardaka. Then Ugraganda, you all people experience the Ugraganda of Rasona, because it produces a pungent smell or prominent pungent smell. So it is known as Ugragandha. Then Yavanesta. It is liked by the Yavan people as an adjunct of food. So it is known as Yavanesta. These are the important synonyms of Lasuna. Then classical categorizations. As I have told in the beginning, this plant is not included in any Mahakasaya or Gana in Brihatrayi, but Nigantu people has described in many varga, like Dhanvantari Nigantu mentioned it in Karaviradi varga, Madanpal Nigantu in Sakadi varga, Kaidav Nigantu in Ausadhadi varga, Raj Nigantu in Pipalyadi varga, and Bhaprakash Nigantu in Paritakyadi varga. Then distribution. Garlic is cultivated throughout the world. It is cultivated everywhere. It seems to have originated from Central Asia, then China, and the nearest and the Mediterranean region before moving to Central and Southern Europe, Northern Africa, and Mexico. In India, it is also cultivated in many places like in Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, etc. Then morphology. It is a bulbous perennial herb as seen in the photographs. The height of the herb is 1 to 2 feet. There are so many. It is also used as a vegetable. So it is very small herbaceous species. Then bulb. You have seen this image many times, also use or purchase it from the market. It is rounded, composed of about 15 small bulbets known as cloves, covered with whitish or slightly pinkish tunic or papery coat. Leaves. Leaves are radical. It is arises from the root only, directly from the root. It is linear and flat, near about 4 to 12 in numbers. It is green color, green with seeding base, near about 20 to 30 centimeter long. It is clearly visible in the image. Then flower. It is borne in a dense spherical cluster on a spike up to 25 centimeter long. Then the individual flower stalks arises from the common point. The younger flower head is enclosed in a long beaked pair of bracts which become papery and split to reveal the flower. Flowers are whitish or greenish whitish or sometimes pinkish in color. It is clearly visible in these images. It is found in bunch and whitish in color. Then fruit. Fruit is very small, globose. There are 3 locules, capsule. Seeds is not found in the wild variety, but it may be available or produced under laboratory condition similar to the onion seeds, but it is half in size. Then phenology. Its flowering time is January to March and fruiting time is January to March. Then Rasa Panchak. Its guna is snigdha, chara, tikshna and guru. Rasa is pancharasa. There is absence of amla rasa. The various part of this plant contain different rasa. All the rasas not present in one part, different rasa present in different parts. It is written in the Mahaprasa Nigantu and Kashyapa Nigantu. Its vipaka is katu and virya is usna. Here I want to tell you the sloka of Bhaprakash Nigantu. Panchavishcha rasai yukta rasena amlena varjita. There is devoid of amla rasa. Tasmat rasona ityuktam drabyanam guna vedivhi. Isliye usko rason kaha jata hai. Katukaschapi mulesu. Katurasa is present in root. Tikta patresu sansitam. Leaf has tikta rasa. Nale kasaya muddhistam. Nala means stem. Stem content kasaya rasa. Nalagre lavanam srutam. The tip of the stem content lavan rasa. Bijetu madhuram proktam. The seed of the lasun is have madhur rasa. Rasas tat gunam vedivihi. Different parts of plant constitute different rasa. Then chemical constituent. It contains at least 33 sulfur compounds. The most abundant sulfur compound in garlic is alline or S-allyl-cysteine sulfoxide, which is present at 10 and 30 mg per gram in fresh and dry garlic respectively. The active constituent of garlic are alline, allicin, allexin, allyl methyl trisulfide, diallyl disulfide, methyl allulyl trisulfide, allyl propyl disulfide, S-allyl cysteine, etc. It has also several enzymes. It has mineral like germanium, calcium, copper, iron, potassium, magnesium, and zinc. It has vitamin like vitamin A, B1, and C. It has amino acids like lysine and histidine. The prominent smell of the lahsuan is due to the presence of sulfur compound, diallyl disulfide. Due to the presence of this sulfur content, the lahsuan produces prominent smell. Then action of lahsuan. It has action like balya, or it increases the physical strength. Then bhagna sandhanak, brahman, brishya, deepan, pachan, hridya, rasayan, jantugnam, kanthya, kafahara, medhya, netrya, and varnya. These are the main action of lahsuan as described in the various nighantus. Then action of lahsuan on dosha, dhatu, and mala. It has vata kafahara properties. It produces rasayan, brahman, brishya action. It has also vatanulaman properties. Then pharmacological action. The same thing also as described in the classical text like nighantus. The research also revealed the same type of pharmacological actions, like it is antioxidant, antiparasitic, antidiabetic, antibacterial, anticancerous, antifungal, antihypertensive, antiprotozoal, antitumor, antiviral. It is cardioprotective. This is the most herbal product which is used for cardioprotection. Then digestive, diuretic, hepatoprotective, hypocholesterolemic, lipid. It reduces the hyperlipidemia. Then radioprotective and wound healing properties. Then indication. It has so many indications as shown in the slide. The main are, it is used in Agnimandya, Ajirna, Arsa, Aruchi, Bhagna, Gulma, Hruda, Rok, Jvara, Jirna Rok, Kukshi Rok, Prameha, Hikka, Kasa, Swasa, Kremi, Kukshi Sula, Pushta, Sofa, Vata Vyadhi, and Vibandha. Mainly it is used in the Vata Vyadhi or neurological disorders, then Hruda Rok, and the GI problem. Then contraindication. As Bhagavata told, it should not be used in the condition of Rakta and Pitta. Bhaprakash Nigandu also mentioned the same thing. It is contraindicated for Paitik Prakrut person and Garbhini. In pregnancy also, it should not be used. One should not indulge in doing Vyayama, Atapa, Krodha, and should not also take in excessive water, milk, and Jaggery after use of lahsuan. But it is beneficial to take alcohol, meat, and sour drug after intake of the garlic. It is clearly mentioned in the Bhaprakash Nighantu. I want to tell the sloka of Bhaprakash Nighantu. Madhya mangsa tatha amlamsa hitam lahsuan sevina. Means it is beneficial to take alcohol, meat, and amladravya during the intake of garlic. But vyayamam, atapam, rosam, Ati niram payogudam roshanam asmanan purushas tyajat etan nirantaram. The person who are taking lahsuan should not be use or indulge vyayama, atapa, rosha, as I have told earlier. Then therapeutic uses. As I have told earlier, it is mainly used in vata vyadhi. Oil cooked with lahsuan juice, elevated vata, Arasuna is the best remedy for Vata, as by Prakash Nikantu. Then Visamjwara, Arasuna mixed with oil should be used before meals. Arasuna mixed with ghee can be taken every morning. It is also used in Amavata or rheumatoid arthritis. Arasuna should be given with Shunti and Ingudi in Amavata. Then Kshaya or consumption. One should take Lasuna with milk to treat Kshaya. And it is also used for psychological diseases like Unmada, Upasmara or insanity and epilepsy. One should take Lasuna with oil or Satavari with milk, Brahmi juice or Pushta or Vacha with honey, or Lasunadi Krita prepared with Lasuna and other drugs to treat insanity and epilepsy. Then official part is dose and formulation. The tuber and oil of Lasuna is used medicinally. The dose of this plant is 3 to 6 grams of tuber paste or 1 to 2 drops of oil. Important formulations are Hingu Trigona Tail, Lasunadi Vati, Lasunadya Grita, Lasuna Kshirpak, Rasuna Pinda, Rasuna Astaka, Rasuna Sura, Rasuna Bati, Vacha Lasunadi Tail. And toxicity or adverse effect. Garlic may also act toxic when it is used in overdose. The main side effect of raw garlic intake is the breath odor, or it produces bad smell. Nausea and vomiting are other major side effects. Consumption of garlic also have been reported to be associated with decreased platelet aggregation and bleeding events. Bulb of other species of allium also used as substitution and adulteration of garlic. Then points to be remember here, Rasuna has 5 rasa. Only Amrala rasa is absent. As per Bhav Prakash Nigantu, 5 rasas are present in different parts of the plant. Like Katu, Tikta, Kasaya, Laban and Madhu rasas are present in Moola, Patra, Nala, Nalagra and Bija respectively. Kashyapa also mentions similar type of description, like Bija is Katu rasa, Nala is Laban Tikta ras, Patra is Kasaya ras and Vipak is Madhura. Here you have to remember both the concept of both the part of Mahaprakash Nigantu and Kashyap Samhita. This is the various synonyms mentioned in Mahaprakash Nigantu in the sloka. And this is the properties of Rasuna mentioned in Mahaprakash Nigantu. Rasuna Brahmanam Rishyam Snigdham Usnam Pachanam Saram Rase Pakecha Katukas Tikshno Madhurako Mata Bhagna Sandhana Krut Kantho Guru Pitasra Vruddhidaha Vala Vala Varna Karo Medha Hitu Netro Rasayana Hudroga Ajirna Jwara Pukshi Sula Vivandha Gulma Aruchi Kasa Sofan Durnama Pushta Anala Sada Jantu Samiranam Swasa Kapasa. This is all about the plant Lasuna. Next plant we have also discussed about another Vedanastaka drug. That is the last detailed plant about Vedanastapan. We will discuss in the next class. Thank you.